How you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Very well. What's your name?
Oscar DeAnda. I don't know, a doodler, an illustrator, I guess. No, I always used to watch cartoons and I always try to draw whatever I was watching. It started there, essentially. Then Star Wars happened when I was a stupid young, and that influenced me, I guess, to this day. I always liked the idea of drawing comics. How do you do that? There's always the question, it's like, just doing it, I guess. Because again, like I said, I was always drawing something. I worked at a shop and then, I could do this. This is easy. I know what to do. Yeah, I was very, very much self-taught for sure. I had classes in high school, but you know, it's mostly I've explained it like, I have like a thought in my head of like what I want to do. It could be just one little thing, but it turns into a bigger drawing around it. That's part of the fun, I guess. I just did two comic books for a smaller company called 626 Comics. It's the comic title was Pinata. I had fun with it. Like I've already started to now working on my own book. I'm like, well, why not? It's weird to think that would you go to school? I mean, if I could go back, I think I would. Connecting with people, oh, that's probably important as opposed to just doing it freelance like I've been doing. I like being able to say like, no, I don't want to do that. And I think that would make it not fun as somebody dictating. I'd worked on a comic for 10 years. I was working with another guy called New Guard. Pretty Vague was the other one. Go back and look at older stuff. Look at it and think like, this is pretty basic. And I think I've gotten better. But I mean, that's the thing about art is you should always be improving. Not I've hit my plateau. This is as good as I'm gonna get. It shouldn't be that. You should be trying to push yourself everything, every project, whatever, to do something a little bit better. All right, so I'm gonna attempt. Let's see if I can do it. Let's get this guy down. I'm very influenced by, obviously, American comics. Once I got older, I started looking at Japanese comics. From there, I got into European, like French, Jean Giraud, hands down one of the greatest artists. But when he used to do sci-fi, he was called Mobius. I'm not gonna remember the artist who said it, but he said basically, you have to learn anatomy to break it. Learning how to do structure, how to do form. I mostly do alcoholic markers. That's like Copic, Touch. There's a few different brands. It's almost like watercolor because they blend really nicely. They stay pretty vibrant. That's always the pluses. Just give him an axe. Maybe that'll stay. Oh, this. Oh, that's awesome. It's going on the fridge. Oh, it goes in the shell on top of it. Thank you, man. Did you need anything? Okay. Might not be. It is? Okay. I wasn't sure. There's another one with a stance that Kai did, that's a foil also.
Do you have it here?
I do. Time out. This is these are my thumbnails for the book. And this was my original idea for this page. Mm-hmm. Then I like kind of updated it a little bit more. I wanted it to be like, oh, I'm going to try to grab you kind of a drawing. Right. And I went with that. Take a look at that. I still love this drawing. My friend who was just, the guy who was just here who dropped those off, mm-hmm. He's the guy who inked this for me. But he did a bang up job on the inks. There are two covers. It was a cover for a comic book that I guess never came out. It's a, dead poo, like in Winnie the Pooh. And that was the altar. You know, I use just a 0.3 lead, which is probably insane to be using, but it's what I like to use. HB, I like a soft lead. I'm not that heavy-handed. I don't want to tear the paper. And I do have to blame my friend, Thomas Hahn. He's the guy who got me into zebra pens. It's the only pen I like to use. I technically use the pencil as my skeleton. The ink is where I put everything else in there. I used to pencil like to the T. There was no questions. Now it's like, I rather have questions in there, where it's like, oh, I can add to this, subtract to that, especially when you're just hashing out ideas. That's the fun. I don't. No, sorry, bud. I always reference John Byrne, because he was the one guy who said, when you do your paneling, it's easier to look at it and be able to think, does it tell a story? Can you read it without any words? It's got to be simple enough for the reader to follow it. It's just, you have to have the eye to make sure it flows without dialogue. You should be able to tell a story without telling it. Comic books is a visual medium. Clearly, there's drawings to go with your words. All-time influence. I think he's like the greatest artist in the comics right now. It's Arthur Adams. He's known for Longshot. Eventually became an X-Men character. Mike Mignola, too. I like his work a lot. You know who Jack Kirby is at all? Kirby's technically the guy who created most of the stuff. Dan Lee is sort of the writer.
Give me good art or just this garbage?
Just that garbage. The current thing that I'm trying to do is I wanted to have three done. I'm pretty sure I only want to do four to start it off with. And if that does good, I could do four more and then four and four and four. I got to be a little bit more realistic when it comes to it being independently made. At least my version of Calvin Hobbes. Again, it's one of those things like, I never feel satisfied. And that's kind of the point. And if you feel satisfied, I think you should feel bad about yourself. Because that's not the point. The point is to get better. At a young age, I got knocked on really hard. And I didn't know how to take that. And the guy's like, oh, no, this is crap, blah, blah, blah. And he just roasted me. I stopped licking my wounds and started looking, I guess, closer at page layouts and on the page, left to right, all that fun stuff. It's putting all that stuff together is the hard part. it's in a weird spot right now, for sure. Like, all my friends who I've met in the industry pretty much aren't doing this anymore, which to me sucks. Because of the corporatist side of it, I guess. I don't know. They just want product. They don't want quality. I can't imagine there being not something that hasn't been touched, at least a little bit. It's just, has it been successful or not? There's always the question. The O in the box. That's usually how I sign off on the drawing. Came from, I was looking at battery covers and I was just like, oh, that I could just put my O in that. That's why it's got that little bit at the bottom. It's where the screw goes in. I had an idea already what I wanted to do, like black out the background and just have them kind of lit. It's from a script. The comic was called Pretty Vacant. It came out. This is the page that pissed me off. Because I did this, and what he did is he took this page and then copied it, cut it up, and made it panels. That's not what I wanted you to do.
You're making moves in this industry. You know, you have to.
Unfortunately, yes. That's the hard part, is really balancing all that. I tend to draw late at night, 10 to 3 to 4 in the morning. So it's how I've always done it.
Do you think your art is figurative drawing? Is it storytelling?
Storytelling. I think it's storytelling. When you're doing comics, you're trying to tell a full tale as fast as you can and as succinctly as you can and solid enough for people to be like, oh, that was good. In theory, yes, it's that. And that is another thing that's really hard with art, because this is something that's personal to whoever's doing it themselves. You go to a dark, dingy room, or you go to wherever you want and pour your soul into this. Ultimately, the craziest thing, because art is so personal to me, or to you, or to whoever's putting it out. It's all personal. You had an idea, you put it down. It doesn't matter. If you handed me something, I could tell that. And that's my ultimate goal. It is very, very fast. It's very fast paced. Comic books come out once a month. That's always the hard part. So I do have to give respect to anybody who does this on a monthly level. Then consistency is the hard part. That's the important part. Everybody knows who Stan Lee is, but very few people know who Jack Kirby is. And that's the problem. But eventually, there's going to be that documentary where it's like, this is how much he was involved. This is how much this person was involved. Jack Kirby essentially passed away pretty broke. It was the same thing with Bill Finger. He's the guy who actually created Batman, not Bob Kane. Bob Kane just came up with the name. Bill Finger pretty much did everything else. Most people don't know. Jack is an influence on every comic book artist. Battery cover. Totally. If you don't like it, I don't know why you'd continue with it. Like, I really enjoy, I mean, clearly you know that, because you walked by and saw me just like, drawing the whole day. And that's kind of normal. it's way interesting, and it's really weird to think that, like, oh, I went from wanting to do them, selling them, then doing it. Again, it's always the hard part, right?
Stopping.
Yes.
That's killer.
Somebody has a little bonus.
Yeah.